Hello, Parrish. Kinda scary. Are you scary? He had his ears spin back. Parrish, oh goodness. He's fast, isn't he?
Oh, you good boy.
Ashley got a new picture, so Kevin's hanging it up for her. What does it say?
It's just a constellation. That's not our language.
So yeah, we can't read that. So where are you going to put it? Right above where the TV's going to be?
No, over.
Oh, over on the side. Okay, because you don't know how tall your TV will be. So Ashley, this is the cabinet she bought. I've told you all this before. We're getting her a TV for Christmas. She's patiently waiting. Ashley, how are you watching TV? Like on your computer?
Yeah, if the Wi-Fi would work.
Drives me
insane. Like right here? Oh yeah, that'll be good.
Yeah, that'll
still. Is it gonna be even with the one over here or no?
Up.
Are you not gonna even try?
Hold on, I'm coming. Down.
Yeah, this will be fun. Trying to get these as even as possible.
that's close. Oh, I have crooked eyes. Go down.
She has crooked eyes.
That's now it's too low. Go up a little bit. Go.
You know I'm not gonna get to the park. Room.
Chapel's trying to help.
That's good. No, it's not. Go down a little bit.
Chapel.
That's good. Right there. Don't move it. Stay.
Kevin, pick him up. He was coming towards you.
Can you give me a
wipe up? We're in Target and Kevin found all these Alice in Wonderland, Alice Through the Looking Glass figures. And you have the queen and then you have the cat and the rabbit. Those are so cool.
And the hat.
And the Mad Hatter, yeah. These are back. They're on the back wall. They have these.
He's in the new movie. I don't know who that is.
We haven't seen the new movie yet.
I like the one that has the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man on it, personally.
Where do you see that? Oh, that's a t-shirt. Yeah, those are cute.
I mean, I would never actually wear it. Okay.
Those remind me of those Hallmark things. What are they called? Did you see the Chucky? Bride of Chucky. And the Batmobile with Batman?
Yeah, they're Borderlands and Skyrim. That's cool. Andrew would like that. Not that. He would like the Skyrim.
What is it? A keychain?
No, it's just a little pop vinyl.
He's a keychain.
Oh, it is a keychain. It's a pop vinyl.
So Kevin found some Christmas coloring books. Is this, Kevin, this says color with music. What is that? Color with music, Christmas traditions, color your way to calm.
Oh, it's got a CD.
It comes with a CD. That's pretty though. Yeah, those are nice.
Yeah, it just gives you a CD to listen to.
And then back here, you have a big Halloween man.
That's the second.
Way back there.
The Mercedes something.
They're starting to get their Christmas stuff out in the home section at Target. They have these cookie... Ashley, what are these called? Cookie jars. A cookie jar. And they have gingerbread cookie mix, triple chocolate chip cookie mix, brownie blitz. They have all kinds of cookie cutters. And a book. And this is huge. Kevin and I are making some cookies today, so I decided I'm going to use some of these birthday Hershey Kisses, and I'm just going to plop them right in the middle, and that actually looks really pretty. That looks really, really cute. I like that. Jamie sent me a bag, and Stephanie sent me a bag, and so I had plenty to go around. And so I'll put them in here, and then you just put them in here and you let them firm up. And so so I'll have to try one in just a second and let you know how it tastes with that the peanut butter chocolate cookie. Well, I brought Kevin in to try these because they look really, really good. I'm wondering if you're really gonna be able to still taste that birthday cake flavor.
I'm thinking it's gonna add some just a little bit of vanilla kind of flavor to it. Ooh. It's so warm.
Mm-hmm. Mmm.
Definitely added that vanilla.
Yes. Those have a wonderful flavor.
I don't know if I'd like that as well once they're cooled off and they're hard.
Oh,
I right now it's squishy and mushy.
Mm-hmm.
But they'll harden up once they cool off, won't they?
Oh yeah. I think you'll still like it. I've done the same thing with Hershey's Kisses before. It's just because it's so easy and it looks adorable. I buy the peanut butter cookies and then take just the milk chocolate Hershey's Kisses and stick that down the middle, and it just looks good.
Reese's Cups. I've seen people do those with the little Reese's.
Yeah. Oh yeah. And it's just something easy to do. This is delicious.
It is good. I love this.
So if you all find the birthday cake, just know that that works in cookies.
So they have put some decorations out. They put a big spider on the porch and some zombies. I like the wreath with the owl. And then they have some stuff out front. Berry M Deep. These are cute. Oh, and they have a zombie up in the tree. Yeah, those are really, really cute. And then these people have mums on their porch. Those are pretty. And across the street, they have a flag.
And trick or treat.
Trick or treat. Yeah, I see that. I just think this tree is really pretty because the sun's shining through it. Yeah, that's really nice.
Well, today we have two boxes to open for you. One, I have no idea who it's from. And then the other one is from Eric. Eric in Texas. Eric has gone crazy lately with the HEB stuff, which I personally love, absolutely. But I don't want Eric to spend all his money on us. I worry about that, you know? It says not private. Good, I can read this.
I don't know. They said, Kevin, I love you. I love you to death. I love you more than life.
Where does it say that? It does not say that. Hi, Tammy and Kevin. Love your hauls. Love your blogs and all you do.
I just saw my name.
I've been binge watching your hauls for the third time. And Tammy, everything I see you haul, see, breeze it, reminds me to send you the enclosed. Hope you like this micellar cleansing water. Be sure and shake it first. It won't give you that cool sea breeze feeling, but it's better for your skin and cleans really well. Had to send some candy. Don't know if you tried it. Excuse the note paper. I'm moving and can't find my cute cards. Doesn't that kill you? You buy cute cards and then you need them and you don't know where you put them.
Yeah.
That's okay. You guys make my day, Virginia. Thank you very much. Where's Virginia from?
Oklahoma.
Oh, this is Garnier.
Yeah, Garnier.
Well, thank you. Thank you very, very much.
My cellular
or micellar?
My cellular.
Is it? How do you know that?
It's cellular.
Uh huh.
Or cellar. Cellar. My cellar. I know.
Well, I will try this definitely. I do. I've used Sea Breeze since I was about 12 years old.
Yeah, and then they quit making that one formula, and then she freaked out.
These are we have tried these, or haven't we tried these?
Are these the ones
with sunflower kernels? I think we've tried these.
Maybe I don't remember. I mean, I remember trying sunflower cups, but I don't remember if it was that brand.
Yeah, I think we've tried these. Peanut free.
We like them. Ones we did, we love them.
Yes. I'll have to see if we've tried these or not. If we haven't tried them, we'll do a review. I think we've tried them, though. I think we've tried these, and then there was a red one, too. Maybe one was the milk chocolate and one was the dark chocolate. But Kevin and Andrew actually did the review, and then I tried it afterwards because Andrew was like, you have to try this. I think it's made from sunflower kernels something like that. And they were really, really good. Anyway, thank you very, very much. And I will absolutely try this. The reason I remember the Sebreeze so well is because my mom always used Neutrogena. Neutrogena is that really dark soap, and it's like clear, you can see through it, and it has a very distinct smell. And I don't mind the smell, but I would know it anywhere. It's a very pleasant smell. But so that's all I used was soap on my face until I was about 12. And then I had a slumber party, and it was for my birthday, and one of the girls that spent the night had Sebreeze. And I used it that night, and it took things off my face that I did not know was on my face. It literally, like, you could use soap and then use that afterwards, and you were still getting off
crud
off your face. Yeah. Well,
it's oils and darkness.
Yeah, and so I've used it ever since, and
it's an astringent.
I haven't had any problems at all with my skin. I use the Equate brand, the cheap brand, the Walmart brand, because Sebreeze got rid of the formula that I loved, and they changed it. And I think they may have gone back to the original formula now, but I've never changed back to it, because once I tried the Walmart kind, the Equate, it's like, why would I spend $5 on Sebreeze when I can spend $2.50 on the Equate brand? So Sebreeze lost a customer in me when they changed their formula. I will try this though, I promise. Thank you very, very much.
Interesting side note. Tammy used to do a blog where you literally type.
Oh yeah, I blogged for like 5 years.
A long time. I'd love to be able to recreate that. But we've got the backups of everything. So anyway, she did a blog. One of her most popular posts was griping about Sebreeze and why would you change the formula.
Yeah.
And people were saying this was like this and this is similar to it, and none of it was really the same. And there was rumors about how they were going to bring it back, and it was
people were very, very upset. I mean, I had hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people commenting and saying, thank you for leaving this on the internet, because anytime somebody would find out information, they would go back and they would type a new comment in. Of course, that's gone now. This is from Eric. Eric, oh my gosh, he has sent us some cookies. Ronnie's Real Food Oatmeal Raisin. I've never in my life heard of these, seen these. Okay, these are wheat-free, dairy-free, egg-free. They're all natural, handmade with organic main ingredients. Okay, where are they made? They're made in Austin, Texas. Okay, so we have oatmeal raisin, chocolate chip, and cocoa espresso. And these are Hill Country Fair soft and chewy iced lemon cookies. I have not seen this brand around here. These are made in, I like to tell you if I can read it. Oh, Mexico.
It.
Yeah, it's like he's trying to look over here like he could find anything. Mexico. Somebody
Mr.
said,
Magoo.
Sylvia commented that you needed those magnetic glasses.
They're expensive. They're like $40 a pair though.
Oh, that's not bad. $40? $40 so that you can see all the time?
I could see if I put a regular pair of glasses around my neck. I'm just too lazy to do it.
Seven Select. Okay, is this from 7-Eleven? Let me look.
He usually puts a note in here, but he puts it at the bottom. I guess there.
He's a trickster, that Eric. These are made in Dallas, Texas. It's 7 Select Go Yum Chocolate Chip Mini Cookie Cup.
So 7-Eleven would have 7-Eleven logo.
It would. So these are just 7 Select. Those are awesome. And this is the same thing, but it's triple chocolate mini cookie cups. So one's chocolate chip, one's triple chocolate. H-E-B Chips Galore Chunky. We have never gotten these. Chocolate chip cookies. And they're no high fructose corn syrup, made with real, I thought it said made with real cholesterol. It says made with real chocolate.
Probably made with real cholesterol too.
And H-E-B, of course, is San Antonio, Texas.
These look like Oreo Thins from Japan, but I'll have to see his, maybe he must have.
Eric buys things from other countries and has them shipped to him, so he tries all kinds of snacks. And these look like chocolate Oreo Thins.
He sent us more pecans. We haven't done anything with the other ones yet. They're still sitting over here.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Eric. That's so cool.
Those are from his backyard.
Pecans from your backyard. That's the coolest thing.
It's funny how all the air gets sucked out of you.
I know. It doesn't matter where it's coming from. It all gets sucked out. Central Market HEB sweet and cheese mix. This is popcorn. It's caramel and cheese. I think we've only had that in the,
Chicago mix. Chicago mix as well.
Yeah. And then this is the Central Market caramel corn. I cannot wait to try this stuff. Because Central Market has not let me down yet. I'm impressed with it.
There's
really.
Three of these. That feels like that's a liquid.
That's a cake
just
mix.
Just pour and bake. Wow.
Oh, that is freaking awesome.
There's at least two more in here.
Just pour and bake HEB decadently European chocolate.
That's how all cake mixers should be.
I love this. Yes, this is awesome.
That's how they should all be. Just.
Preheat your oven, lightly grease a round pan, pour batter directly into the pan, and heat for 28 to 32 minutes.
Yeah, that's absolutely. How all wonder what size cake it makes.
Ingenious.
What size pan do you have to use?
9-inch. Which
so a 9-inch round pan?
Yeah.
Or square pan?
Round.
So it makes one round 9-inch pan.
Yeah. Yeah, 9-inch cake. That is awesome. I don't have to add anything. I don't have to do anything. I love it. Okay, and this is maple pecan. Same thing, maple pecan.
And le brownie.
And le brownie. I cannot wait. I've never heard of these. Never seen these. I wonder if these are like brand new. These are awesome. And I love the colors. I love the packaging. It's all just perfect. Love it. Those are awesome. Okay.
Let's open it then.
Pumpkin pie dip mix.
I don't know. I was trying to see how you make
Adam's
it.
Adam's Spice Company.
It's on the bottom, I think.
Okay.
I haven't got that.
Pumpkin pie dip. You take the pumpkin pie dip mix, 8 ounces of cream cheese softened, and 8 ounces of sour cream.
So it's literally like a cheese ball almost.
Yeah. So would you take crackers?
Yeah, that's what I would think.
What kind of crackers? Triscuits?
Everything's good on Ritz.
Kevin likes a Ritz for everything.
You can tell I like Ritz.
What is this? Honey sweet cornbread. This
looks
is
like a
Hill
yellow
County
cornmeal.
Fair.
Looks like a cornmeal mix.
So we
like
have two Hill County Fair brands. It does look like it would be like Jiffy or something like that. And we love cornbread.
Okay, see bottom.
What else is in there? Good grief.
Pumpkin pancakes.
Kirby Lane pumpkin pancake mix. All natural, no trans fats. Twice as nice with pumpkin and spice. So, literally, you take the pancake mix and egg and water, and then you make your pancakes. Or you can make waffles, but we don't have a waffle maker, so we'll have to make the pancakes.
Waffles are easier because you don't have to worry about them burning in the oil.
Peanut butter. HEB made in Texas creamy peanut butter. And this is why I don't buy regular peanut butter. 2 tablespoons is 200 calories.
Yeah,
but you know I'm going to try it for you, Eric. And Kevin still eats regular peanut butter. I have not converted Kevin yet to powdered. Kevin and Andrew will absolutely never agree to the powder.
Peanut butter snob.
So this will be good to have in the cabinet after we try.
You have 2 more things in here. Four.
Helima, is that how you would pronounce that? Helima Sunbest Multigrain Biscuits okay. Chocolate. I know why you sent me these. You sent me these because they are like those digestives.
Mm-hmm, they look just like
from them. England. These look just like them. Wouldn't it be awesome if I could get those in the United States? But I don't recognize this brand.
Mm-hmm.
Where are these made? Hold on. These are made in Holland. They're made in Holland.
Yeah.
www.helima.com. So I probably wouldn't be able to get them anyway. Sweet Tarts gummies?
Texas. They're shaped like Texas. Or they've got bullhorns or something. Yeah, they're shaped like a longhorn steer.
So cool. Variety of fruity flavors. These fruity sweet tarts gummies are 100% game day ready. Share a taste of school pride with your friends with orange longhorns gummies in a variety of sweet fruity flavors. Well, it specifically says orange, But then it says a variety of flavors.
Maybe it was just orange color.
So who knows? That is the most awesome thing ever. I've never seen anything like
steak.
That. That is awesome. Awesome.
These H-E-B cheese.
Cheese, cheddar cheese.
They're like Cheez-Its. Baked,
these are just like Cheez-Its. It will be interesting to see how they rank, how they stack up. What is Andrew's favorite?
Cheez-Its.
Cheez-Its, not like, cheese nips.
I don't like cheese nips either. They don't have the flavor.
We like cheese.
They're not
the
salty.
Sunshine Cheez-Its.
I think so.
Yeah.
One of them's not salty and one of them is.
Right.
And the cheese tastes better than the other.
So we'll have to see how they compare.
Because we've done a comparison video between Cheez-Its and Cheez-Its.
Right.
And none of us like the other one.
No. I mean,
especially when we put them next to each other.
And for years, I was like a cheese nip lover. That's all I would buy. I think truly to goodness, it was because of the box. I like the box was just more attractive to me. And that's what I grew up with. But then you put them side by side, and I'm telling you, the cheese nips do not compare to the Cheez-Its. So this will be a good taste test, but don't get offended if we pick the Cheez-Its again, because...
Two things left.
Okay.
And there's no note. You didn't tell us what the Japanese thing was.
Oh. Central Market. Well, I'm friends with Eric on Facebook.
Yeah, you can just message.
Central Market Cheddar Jalapeno Cornbread Mix.
Sounds good.
That will be amazing, because you know I love jalapenos.
I like baked cornbread anyway.
Stunning combination of real cheddar cheese and flavorful jalapenos. Easy to make, hard to resist.
Last thing.
Thank you. Oh, wow. H-E-B.
I saved the most evil.
Yeah.
Relax.
H-E-B granola, triple chocolate granola. Chocolate granola with dark chocolate chunks and white and milk chocolate rolls.
Mm-hmm. Looks good.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow, look at all the flavors out.
They have classic... granola with nuts, granola with vanilla and pecans, with raisins, with strawberries and yogurt, and with berries. He sent us the best one.
The chocolate
one. Yeah, you sent me the one that I would want. Yes, this is awesome. It says, chocolate for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and dessert. How deliciously decadent. With chocolate three ways, chunks of rich dark chocolate, creamy white chocolate, smooth milk chocolate, and crunchy whole oat flakes for inspiration. I can't believe I never knew about this. This is awesome. I think I'm just so impressed with the things in this box.
Mm-hmm.
Very impressed. I'm very impressed with this. I think this is amazing. These cake mixes, I'm telling
cool.
you, this is the wave of the future. Really, this is it. I
love
this.
It'd be nice if they did. I wonder if they're more expensive because they have to put their own stuff in there.
I don't know.
And they can't put eggs in it, so.
Well then, I mean, what?
Do they not say, well, they might have eggs in it.
Yeah, I mean, it would have to, well, it might not have eggs in it, but wouldn't it say vegan if it didn't have eggs in it? Wouldn't
not
that be
other
a,
stuff.
Wouldn't that be a great big selling point?
But probably, maybe it has egg powder. I'm just thinking you can't really have eggs, like, maybe, I don't know, they have shelf-stable meals where they put meat and potatoes and stuff
right.
in, so I guess it's okay, yeah.
Well, I love
it's
these.
Cool.
I yeah, hope I that we get stuff like this here. I'm very, very impressed with all of your selections. Absolutely love it. Virginia, thank you very much. And Eric, you know, you've spent a lot of money on us. I could never repay you. This is wonderful. Kevin, I'm going to put you on the spot now. Jean sent me a message a little while ago on Facebook, and she asked me to ask you your opinion of something, so I'm going to. And I said, I'll put him on the spot on camera when we do this box opening in just a minute, because he doesn't read Facebook. He doesn't get on Facebook. And then she asked me about this, and then Amanda gave it a thumbs up, so I know Amanda wants to hear your opinion as well. They want to know, what was your opinion of last night's episode of Walking Dead? I did not watch it. I decided when I saw the season finale, I've watched all of them, but when I saw the season finale and what it was gonna be like this season, I decided for my own sanity,
for my own well-being,
truly to goodness, for my own mind, I need to sleep at night. And I decided that it was going to be too much for me. And honestly, from comments I've seen on Facebook, I've heard that it was extremely
graphic,
gruesome.
It was
graphic. I've heard over and over again that people could not sleep last night.
It was horrific. It was very, very graphic. It's something you would see in a horror movie. I mean, literally, I thought it was. It was bad.
I'm so glad I didn't watch
yeah, you don't
truly. It just upsets me thinking about it. I'm really glad I didn't watch it.
The overall, it follows the... I read all the comic books. So this one actually catches you up a little bit with the comics.
Mm-hmm.
And should I say spoilers if I'm going to say something?
Yeah, because this vlog will be out Monday, and by then another Walking Dead will have come out, and if they're going to watch it, they would watch it in a week.
All right. Well,
you know what I mean?
I'm just going to say spoiler right now.
Yeah. The second episode will have happened.
Pause it.
The night before this comes out.
I mean,
out.
Turn the sound off, whatever. The redheaded guy, which I can never remember his name.
Abraham.
He died a while back in the comics. I mean, at this point in time in the comics, he had already died. Glenn dies by him with the baseball bat. I mean, he died exactly like what was in the comics. I mean, it's the exact same thing. I'm assuming they're probably going to follow a similar story arc to the comic. If it does, it'll be a good story. But right now, he had to... I mean, if you were insane and you were trying to break someone to make them bend to your will, and as bullheaded and as strong a leader as Rick is, you would almost have to do something drastic. Maybe not that crazy psychopath drastic, but you would have to do something drastic to break him, and that's what he did to break him, and it did. Broken.
Did it show it, or was somebody talking about it or going up?
Oh no,
it, or?
They showed it. Rick was remembering.
Okay.
Rick was remembering back, and he was seeing him in his mind.
Because someone on Facebook was saying just the retelling of it was
yeah,
just...
Yeah, he was watching it in his mind, what happened.
Mm-hmm. And was there something about a child's arm?
Yeah. The guy told him, to really have my trust that you understand what I'm saying, his son.
Rick's son?
Yeah. He made him put his arm out, and he tied a tourniquet around it, put a line on it, and said, here's an axe, cut it off. And he was about to, I mean, because everybody else was gonna die if he didn't, and then he's gonna kill him anyway, and then kill him. So he ended up in the air, and then he stopped him or something. I never got to understand how he stopped him, because he didn't say stop or grab it or anything like that. He just didn't do it. So anyway, so it was pretty
I'm going to be honest.
Intense.
If I had to live in a world like that, I would
rather not live.
I wouldn't be around. I just wouldn't. Yeah. That's just the truth. And a lot of you would say, oh, that's a sin. And you know, but I'm telling you, if it got that bad where we lived in a world like that, I mean, what's the point?
Yeah.
Really?
Well, the Walking Dead, it's, and if you read any of the main guy, which he lives about, 30 minutes away?
Yeah, they're the guy who wrote it, they're in Richmond. We've been to Richmond. When we went to IHOP and reviewed, I think they were like red velvet pancakes or something, that was in Richmond.
And that, that was in Berea. But anyway, he lives right there. He's always said that these comics aren't about the zombies. The zombies are just a secondary thing. It's really about people and how they react to horrible situations. And that's what this is. And it's really the people are the evil people, not the zombies. Zombies are just mindless animals, basically.
But as a man, did that not disrupt your sleep?
It didn't disrupt my sleep, because I've watched scary movies for all my life. And my dad always said, you know, you just got to remember they're not real.
No, but knowing that people could be that evil.
The West, if you haven't watched, still spoilers.
I'm not watching Westworld either, though. I told you that.
Westworld's the same way, and
yeah,
that's more civilized.
Can't do it.
But people, some people, I think, can be, if given the opportunity,
would take advantage
100% of being as evil as they possibly could get away with. I 100% believe there's a lot of people.
And for me, that's wrong.
That's
a problem. There's a
perfectly
if you
normal.
Feel that way, I really think that there's a problem.
I think there's people that run around perfectly normal that hold on to keep themselves from doing crazy stuff because of societal rules and norms.
Mm-hmm.
That if they didn't have those societal rules and norms, they would act crazy. Just like, what's The Purge? The Purge is the exact same thing. They're saying, you know,
yeah, I can't
do whatever you want.
That.
It's the same.
Yeah.
It's the same theory.
Basically. Principle. Yeah. So, did it upset you a lot watching that to see that?
It was very graphic, and it was. Like I said, do they need to be that graphic on TV?
Sorry, the camera cut off. Go ahead.
Does it need to be that graphic? probably not. You probably could have told the same story without being that graphic. I mean, I've seen horror movies that scared me worse, and they didn't show a tenth of what this one did.
But you'll continue to watch it.
I'll continue to watch it just because, like I said, it doesn't bother me.
And you're invested in it.
And I know this is completely fake. The guy that did get his head beat in got up and went home, you know, to his kids. Right. You know, that doesn't bother me because I know it's not real.
Right.
Is it disturbing seeing that kind of stuff? Yeah. And now are we desensitized to it? Probably somewhat. But for me, it's not that's a horrific event, something that actually occurred. To me, it's just actors acting out of part. It would be no different than going to a play or anything like that. To me, it's not real, so I don't overthink it, I guess. I'm more surface level thinking about it, I guess.
I just want to see happier, I guess, stuff. Yeah. Cold art, you know? It's apples and oranges. Yeah, you can't even compare them.
No.
But maybe the older I get, I just don't want all that going on in my head. I don't want to see all that. So, anyway, I told Gene that you would give an update.
That's how I feel. I'll keep watching it. It was disturbing, way more graphic than it probably needed to be, especially with Glenn. That was like over the top. And
one more thing, the cookies that we showed you just a little while ago before this box opening, I remember I told you that you can take milk chocolate and put it in the middle of the cookies, and I put the birthday the rainbow in the middle of the cookies. They never got firm.
Yeah, they stayed runny, the squishy.
The milk chocolate chips, when I do that in a peanut butter cookie, they get they stay firm and they're perfect. You will not be able to use these birthday cake kisses. That's what I'm talking about. The birthday cake kisses, you won't be able to use those, I don't think, in cookies. They never got firm.
They never got soft. I mean, they were always soft.
Yeah, so I
don't... sticky. I mean, like, you could touch them and they would stick to your finger.
Yeah, I don't know why, but I wouldn't recommend you doing that. Or if you do it, only do it with a couple of cookies and see how it works out before you do it with the whole batch, because then you can't stack them at all because they turn to mush.
Oh, a good flavor.
Yeah, oh, excellent, excellent flavor. Eric, let me raise you up. Kevin is opening some of these pecans.
Most I got pear flowers.
A pair of pliers. We don't have a nutcracker. Yeah. You would think most people would have those. We just don't. My parents, I think I've said it before in videos, at Christmas they would buy a bag of the nuts. And they had it was like a wooden bowl. Mm-hmm. It was square that sat on the table, and it had the metal
little picks and the crackers.
Yeah, a pick. It had a pick so you could dig down in there. Is this them?
Mm-hmm. They may taste good, but boy, it's sure a lot easier to go buy them in a bag.
Those are so good. So, so, so good. Very good, aren't they? It's hard to believe that these are out of his yard.
Yep, just get them out of your yard.
That's amazing to me. Thank you very much for sending us these, because when we buy them around here, they're expensive. Now, I'm wondering if they're not cheaper in Texas because you have so many there. For us, we just bought a huge bag at Costco, but that's not the norm. The norm is probably, what, $5 a pound?
Probably
$5 a pound.
You can see where that costs the most, huh?
Yeah, you'll have to let us know how much they charge in your area since you all have them, because I would just think that they would be a lot cheaper.
You would see why they would cost a lot, though.
Mm-hmm.
So much trouble they are to get them just out of the shells.
I wonder if there's an easier way to do this.
Probably.
Like with a machine.
I'm sure.
You think a machine has
definitely easier than what I'm doing, I'm sure.
Well, this is good. This is what Kevin's like when we go to like Texas Roadhouse, and they have those huge barrels of peanuts. Kevin treats me like the baby.
Yeah. I'll crack open peanuts and I'll eat one to her five. Cause I'm
but cracking he'll hand them to me. Yeah, he'll crack them open and he'll hand them to me and let me eat them. But
I don't mind.
So that I don't have to do it myself. That's very good though. I could stand here all day and just eat these.
Mm-hmm, they're very good.
But thank you very, very much. Hello from the bathroom. I am
cleaning the bathroom right now. That's why there's a bad camera angle. I've already cleaned the tub and shower and the mirror and vanity. And now I'm on to the toilet. The lovely toilet. But I want to tell you all some news that I just got. My sister works, she has a full-time job with the state. She has a really good job. It pays well. The only negative thing is it's out of town and she has to commute a long way there and a long way home. I hate that for her. But for, there are certain circumstances that have arisen to where she's had to have a second job. So the second job is at a restaurant in our town. And we have never been there. It is an upscale restaurant and meals are not cheap. That's why Kevin and I have not been there. Kevin and I, when we go out to eat, we usually eat, we eat cheap. We eat Chick-fil-A or Culver's or, I mean, yes, we've been to like Texas Roadhouse and places like that, but even going to the Cheesecake Factory, it kills us, or it kills me at least, because I don't like spending that much money on a meal. I don't like to go spend $100 on food. I just don't. It doesn't make me feel good. When I could fill up at Culver's for $20, you know. So anyway, that's why we haven't been to this restaurant. Okay, that said, she called me. I'm going to clean the toilet while I'm talking to you all about this. She called me last week, and she said that they are filming a reality show in the restaurant this week. They are going to be filming for Vanderpump Rules. And she told me the girl's name. She said, this girl is from Winchester and she's on Vanderpump Rules. And I said, well, Jennifer, I don't watch that show. I said, I tried to watch the first episode of it because I watched The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. And Lisa Vanderpump is on The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. So I know who Lisa Vanderpump is. And so I thought I would watch Vanderpump Rules. And it all seemed so contrived. It really did. And I know all the Real Housewives shows are like that, but I don't know. For some reason, this one just, it was like more like the Kardashians. Like Keeping Up with the Kardashians, it was like very, very, very contrived. So I watched the first episode of Vanderpump Rules, didn't watch it anymore. I thought, this just does not interest me. So anyway, she said one of the girls from Vanderpump Rules is from Winchester and they're going to be filming for that show in this restaurant next week. So I said, well, that's really cool. And so she told me the girl's name and I immediately recognized it. Her sister, back before we moved into this house, next to our house, there was a rental house. It wasn't rental when we bought it, but then some people bought it and it became rental. Anyway, her sister rented the house for a time next door to us. But then I've known their family for a long time because we went to church together years and years ago. I went to church with the family. And so this is a small town, okay? So you don't get away with much in this town. Anyway, she's coming into town. They're filming for this reality show. So I said, well, that's really cool. And I said, you better look good because they're all going to look good. And my sister always looks really nice anyway. She always does her hair and makeup and her nails and her tan and all that stuff. She's more high maintenance than me. But anyway, so she called me just now. I'm cleaning out the bathtub and she calls me and she says we're supposed to be there today at 2 because they're going to set up to film. And she said the boss wants the restaurant to look full, like, you know, like people are in there eating. And so could you come and sit there and he'll give you free food if you come. And so I'm like, sure. If you can pick me up, I'll come. So, I don't have any hopes at all being on the show at all whatsoever. I'm sure that I'll never be shown. That's fine. But it will be cool to see. I'm going to really be paying attention to how much of this, how much are they directing this? Are they letting the people walk in and do their thing and just let it happen as it happens? Or are they telling them what to say? You know, I just want to see how this goes because I don't know anything about it. If I can film anything, you know I will. I will sneak out my camera, my phone. But now if I walk in and they say specifically you can't film anything, then I'm not going to try. I'm not going to try to be underhanded because I don't want to get kicked out. But I will, I'm not gonna ask permission. I would rather film and then worry about getting permission later or not at all. You know, it, usually I just don't ask at all. I just go with it.
Okay, this is the outside of where we're gonna be filming. This is the Engine House Deli and we're right downtown. Getting out of a truck and he has a camera. He has a camera and he's gonna be coming inside. He has a walkie-talkie on his side and he has something in his ear. There's also two women walking around who have something in their ear. So this is the meatball sub. And I don't know what kind of, how do you open it up? Oh, that's it, that's the cheese. You eat it with a fork? Oh, okay. And what is this? Cubano?
Mm-hmm.
Turn around here, let me see. What all does it have on it?
It's got pulled pork and ham on it.
And this is meatballs and cheese, and these are the chips. You pay a dollar extra for the chips?
Fries.
For the fries. Sorry, the fries. I didn't get the chips.
But this is just his sandwiches. I mean, he does special.
Yeah, silver butter we keep right here. You have to eat it with a fork. Yeah. It's butter pecan ice cream. See, I can't eat that ice cream. It'll make me sick. Why? Because I'm lactose intolerant. I can't eat any of that stuff no more. I've been that way for a couple of years now. Usually they're warm. Mmm, that's good. You can taste the bourbon. Mm-hmm. You sure can. I don't even like to drink bourbon. Oh, really? Yeah, I like it. Now, that brownie's the bomb.
I'm gonna go with the Rufus.
Yeah, that sounds good.
I don't really like coleslaw.
You don't like coleslaw?
Okay.
No coleslaw and I'll do french fries.
Yeah, I last night. He was from England. And he came. He was working at a factory here for a week. You wouldn't believe how many people come in town just for these factories.
Check back in with you about the reality TV deal because I don't want to forget anything. My sister picked me up and we went down there to where she works part-time, and we ate, and as we're eating there are people coming in, and they're first of all, they had to look around the restaurant and see where the best location to film was. Well, it turned out that it was literally the table right behind us. And it's funny because I had wanted to move. I was worried that they would sit back in a corner somewhere. If we had moved, we wouldn't have probably had as good a seats as what we had. So they picked out the table behind us. And then they set up the cameras. They had this, they had some stuff that tents that they put up in front of the door, that tinted the door. And so that darkened it in there a little bit because it was really bright from the light shining right in there. Also, the music was really loud when we first went in and sat down because nobody was there yet. But then once they arrived, then there was no music on. I'm pretty sure there was no music on, which makes sense because I guess when they're doing these scenes in reality TV, you don't hear any music behind them, or they would have to pay rights, I guess. But it wasn't the girl who I thought was going to be there. It was her boyfriend. So the girl who I thought it was going to be was going to be Brittany Cartwright. She's the one that is from Winchester. However, it wasn't her that came in. It was Jax Taylor, which is her, I don't know if it's her fiance or her boyfriend or what, but it was Brittany's grandmother. I'm pretty sure it's Brittany's grandmother and Jax. And Jax, apparently this was not for Vanderpump Rules. They are filming their own reality show. And my sister and I had to sign a consent saying that it was okay if they showed our faces. And then the table behind them had to sign the same consent form. And I said, "What is this for?" And he said, "It's for a reality TV show." And I said, "Yeah, but what's the name of it?" And he said, "Well, it doesn't have a name yet." He said, "This is going to be," he said, "This is like the first episode. This would be like the first episode." And he said, "So it doesn't have a name." So apparently they're both on, they're both on Vanderpump Rules, and this is going to be a reality show apparently about him moving away from California and coming to Kentucky and maybe living on a farm or leaving the big city life for the farm life. I don't, like a Green Acres type thing. I don't know. Does that not sound like Green Acres?
You're showing your age.
Oh, Kevin said I'm showing my age. Surely y'all know what Green Acres is. Anyway, that's what it sounds like to me. So I only got like the side of his face,
in the back of his head. I know y'all are going to be disappointed, but I was sitting, he was at the table behind us, and he was actually pointed the other way. It was her grandmother that was pointed towards me. So you can see her grandmother, but him, you could only see the side of his face because they were looking at something on the wall. And so you get to see it then, but then the rest of it is like the back of his head. We did overhear some conversation where they were just talking about, she said something like, the boys took you wolf hunting, and he said, yeah, but we didn't find any wolves. And then they were talking about something about her weight that, you didn't tell her she'd gained weight, did you? Talking about him telling Brittany, and he said, no, I would never say anything like that. And so, I mean, she hasn't. And it was just part of the conversation that they had. They were talking about basic, really, really basic stuff. At one point, I'm assuming it was a producer, came up and whispered something in the grandmother's ear. And then she walked away. And I mean, literally only, he would not have been able to hear what she said. Only the grandmother would have been able to hear it. It was like directly in her ear. And then she walked away. So maybe she was telling her, bring up this subject or bring up that subject. Or I don't think she was telling her what to say at all. But she might have just been bringing up subject material, you know, which is, you know, fine. And so she did that once, and then later on she stepped in one other time to him. He had said something during the conversation, and then she stepped in to say, but remember you said earlier blah blah blah, so you need to clarify that. And he immediately was like, oh yeah, I need to clarify this with the grandmother. So there was no lines fed at all. There might have been, you know, well, talk about the last movie you saw. You know, she might have been giving them ideas in the grandmother's ear that one time, but that's all that I saw at all. It was surprising to me. It was also surprised that nobody in the restaurant knew that this was going down. I mean, you could tell when we went in there, when my sister and I walked in there, people were in there eating their meals, and a lot of people got up and left, and it's like, well, they have no idea, you know, what's getting ready to happen, or they wouldn't have left. And then people that were in there eating, some of them were like, you know, you could tell that they were looking around wondering what was going to be going on. So it's not like that was staged or anything. I think what they do as the crew, it seemed like to me, is that they wait to see who's actually going to be still sitting there at the time of filming. And it was very clear that my sister and I were not getting up. Even though we had eaten our food, we were not leaving. And so, and the same with the guys at the, there were like four skater guys at a table at the other end of the restaurant. It was clear that they were not going to be leaving while the filming was going on. So that's why they got them to sign forms. But who knows if this will ever air or not. If it does air, if I ever hear of this, I'm going to keep my ear out, because if it does air, then I'm going to be watching this first episode, because if they got somebody's face, they wouldn't have gotten my sister's face. They would have definitely gotten my face, because the camera was pointed this way. I would be like directly behind him. You would be able to see like his face talking, and then if you saw anybody in the background, you would be seeing either my sister's blonde hair or my face. So who knows? Like I said, it might not ever see the light of day, but I thought, you know, it was a fun adventure. I thought that was neat to get to see something like that. I thought it was really, really cool. And so I hope that you all enjoy whatever footage I got. I'm gonna try to slow down the part where you can see the side of his face, just so that the people who do know him will know, yes, that's Jax Taylor. He walked in, I'm gonna be honest, he walked in and I think he had walked in back and forth a couple of times and I didn't even know it was him. The only thing they did set up, I forgot to mention, was they had him walk in like at least twice before they actually ordered their mail. So like they came in and they sat down at the table and they waited a second and then they got up and I told my sister, I said, they just got up and left. Well, because they made them come back and do it again. So they did make them like rehearse that part, the entry part, but that was it. So here's how this tree's looking now. And we're gonna go through the leaves again, yay! And there's another blow up, Halloween blow up over there that's appeared just over the last week. We have another box opening for you. This is from Brock in Nebraska. So, what have we received from the great state of Nebraska? I'm peeking. Oh, there's a card. Let me see the card. Oh, and it's a Halloween card. I figured it was because it was orange, but I was afraid to say so. It says, wishing you miles and miles of pumpkin smiles. Happy Halloween. Hi, Tammy. Here are some items I picked up at World Market for you. I hope you enjoy. I love watching your channel. You have a great family. Take care, Brock. Thank you so much. I desperately want to go to World Market.
We'll go with something.
We'll see when we go. It's like 2 hours away. It's in Louisville, but they do have a World Market there. And oh wow, goodness gracious, World Market. These are coffees. We have chocolate peppermint, red velvet, fireside rum, which sounds really good. I like rum. Holiday eggnog. And this is a holiday blend. So it's just a smoky blend. I cannot wait to try these. These all sound really good. And they sound very, very different. So I like that.
And something to put it in.
Oh, cool. From Nebraska. Thank you. It says, there's no place like Nebraska. There's no place like Nebraska, dear old Nebraska U, where the girls are the fairest, the boys are the squarest of any old place that I know. There is no place like Nebraska where they're all true blue. We'll all stick together in all kinds of weather for dear old Nebraska U. I'm sure that's a song
that's
for
their fight song or something.
Yeah, like we're gonna fight, 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 yeah. Thank you so, so much. I will have to, in honor of you, Brock, I will have to drink all of these coffees out of this cup. I really like that. I appreciate that. And I will keep that with my other mugs. Right now, I have them on display in the dining room. And then when I'm trying something or have something good, then I pull them in here. And so they're always clean, you know, because I'm constantly using them. But I will definitely be using this for these. Thank you very, very much. Bless you.
Where's your coffee?
Today, Kevin and I got a package from Natalia in Texas. So I brought scissors, but it looks like we're going to be able to open it right up. I'm surprised I'm getting to open this. Normally, Kevin likes to.
I was letting you do the hard part.
Kevin!
There's a piece of paper. Now I'm going to read it.
Hey.
She has Green and Henry.
Hey, Tammy and Kevin. My name is Natalia, and I have been watching y'all's channel for quite some time now. I must say, I love you too and your videos. You have a beautiful family. It always makes me happy to watch your reviews and vlogs. I go to Southern Methodist University in Dallas, and our libraries always put out snacks. I was hoping y'all would try some and let me know your thoughts. There's two packs of granola bites by Bare Naked. Mm-hmm. My favorite is the peanut butter and honey. We've had peanut butter and honey Bare Naked. We've had these. We actually did a review of these. And I also found an apple crisp Nature Valley. Yes. Yes, we had a discussion about this. I've never seen them in stores. However, Amazon sells them. I love Nature Valley. Tammy, my favorite is the peanut butter as well, but would love to hear y'all's thoughts on the apple crisp to see if I should order some from Amazon. I wish you all the best and happy Halloween, Natalia. Also added my school's hot cocoa mix. Hope you like it. That's all we drink in the winter. That's awesome.
Right.
Well, just know, this is what happened with these. We have tried both of these. What happened with these was we bought these these in a bigger bag at Kroger, and we tried them with a few other products. So then Kevin and I found these little packages, both of these. Kevin and I did a review of both of these together. Well, I thought, gosh, these sound so familiar, and they seem familiar. Well, I looked on my own channel, and there we go. We had these bites. So I deleted the video of us doing these together because I thought, what's the point of showing us trying these together when we've already done the video of just these? So just know these are very good. We liked both of them. We will enjoy both of these, but I've already done a review of them, so you won't see a review of these, but thank you for getting them for us. They sell these at our local Kroger, and they're very, very good. The apple crisp, you're right. I've never seen Nature Valley Crunchy Apple Crisp, and I'm thinking, I want to say Kevin has told me that his favorite is the apple crisp. He lives in Canada, so if I'm right about that, Kevin, you can comment. He lives in Canada, and maybe in Canada these are really popular. I don't know, but you're right. I've never seen these here. We'll definitely try this, and we will absolutely try this. We'll do these in the same video. It'll be a Natalia video from Texas, and you just add hot water, and it magically turns red.
Mm-hmm, it's all
right. That's cool.
Let's see the school colors.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Thank you very, very much. I appreciate it. Can't wait to do this review. And thank you for the extra little goodies, too. Even though we've tried them, I think that's cool. I like it when people send us stuff that we've tried before. That way, we can just open it and enjoy it.
Mm-hmm. They're painting this house over here. It was purple for a long time, and they're painting it blue. And it looks like they have a new window maybe downstairs, or maybe it just looks like a new window because they've painted around it. Looks really, really nice. Kevin found a restful sleep machine, so he's trying to figure out which one he would sleep to. That is a heavy, that's heavy. That's a lot of rain.
That sounds like the fan.
It does. What is tranquil? No.
I think that one.
I think the ocean. What is rainforest?
It's the rain. It's the bugs. That would drive me crazy.
Yeah, because you're... you. Okay, what's meditate? And calm? And what's campfire?
Fire, that's not bad.
What's stream?
Well, running water, that wouldn't be bad.
What was the peace one? No, the ocean. We would only ever have it on the ocean, and that would be it. $20 at CVS. We're in Big Lots, and Kevin found these lighters for your grill, but they're fishing poles. And yeah, those are cool. I think you should get one of those for your dad.
He's got, we got one.
Look, I know, but it's probably out. We bought him one a couple years back, and it was a gun. It was like a machine gun or something. But this is neat. You don't want to get him one for something different? No?
So we've been to a bunch of stores, and unfortunately we haven't Christmas shopped at all. We bought stuff, food for us, and we bought stuff to review, and we bought Kevin some sweaters, which I'll show the stuff when we get home, what we got. But we're at Culver's and sitting in the car just like we did a couple weeks ago. It's been probably, what, 2 weeks ago, 2 or 3 weeks ago? We ordered the exact same food that we ordered before, didn't we? I got French fries, Kevin got French fries, we got a meal. And I got diet root beer to drink, and I got the same chicken fingers that I got in that meal. Now, in that video. Now, you had ordered a special burger that time.
Not last time.
I think. No?
No. No, usually I get a pub burger, but they didn't have them anymore.
Oh, okay.
Those are just a double box.
But they do have their pumpkin stuff out now. Mm. Milkshake or concrete mixer. So anyway, I just want to tell you, we've been shopping. I've tried to show, I filmed a little bit in the stores. I've tried to film some Christmas videos for you all. So hopefully, if they're not out yet, hopefully they'll be out soon. And I'll check in with you in a little bit. Well, today I have two things to open. I've already slit this open before we started filming. Look how cute that is.
That is cute.
That is adorable. That looks like a chapel.
Yeah, it does.
As a kitten. Hope Halloween's a special blend of magic and fun beginning to end. Dear Tammy, Kevin, Guido, and family, happy Halloween. Hope your Halloween is a great one with lots of fun and goodies. Thanks for sharing your videos. I enjoy watching them each day. Sincerely, Molly. And Molly lives in California. Thank you, Molly. Wonder how she got the...
She might have slid it in the printer and printed it.
It actually has printed writing on it.
She writes that name.
No way. It actually had, well, I read it to you, so I'm going to go ahead and show it to you. It's actually printed on the card. I mean, that's awesome. That's pretty cool. I haven't seen that before. Thank you. I love that. I will add that to my collection out in the other room as soon as we finish this video. This. Hi, Tammy, Kevin, Ashley, Christina, Andrew, Gavin, Amelia, and especially Guido. We hope that you enjoy these Halloween treats. Have a spooktacular Halloween. Lots of love, Jennifer, Nathan, and Mike. P.S. I'm especially excited about the fizzy popcorn. Boo. And they drew a ghost. This is from England, from Jennifer, Nathan, and Mike. And they have their own channel, if you haven't checked it out. JNM Vlogs, all one word. Ooh, Cadbury Pumpkin Patch Cakes. I'm so excited about these. Oh, and we've tried these. It says you have to try these OMG Amaze Bites on the back. We actually bought those when we were there. And I'm pretty certain I finished both containers before we left England. I'm pretty sure. Oh, I wanted these. I saw a picture of these.
They're terrible.
Yes. Yeah, I really, really wanted these. I'm so glad you sent these. Toffee, and we didn't try the toffee. We tried the Viennese Whirls,
right.
But not toffee flavored.
M&S.
M&S, no tricks, just treats, sweet and sour gruesome gargoyles, and Super scary fizzy spiders. Those sound awesome. I wonder if they'll really be fizzy in your mouth.
Yeah, it's their powder is fizzy stuff.
And M&S popping candy spiders. Solid milk chocolate discs. They go pop in your mouth. I didn't expect anything from M&S. Thank you very much. I was just expecting Mr. Kipling. So I'm glad you sent the Cadbury as well. Ooh. Wicked Witch's hats. And they're actually shaped like hats. These are really cool. When we do the video, I'll have to show you all, because these are black currant, orange, and raspberry flavored jelly sweets. I'll have to take a close-up of all these because they're really cute. Fizzy Fantastic. Oh, I'm sorry. Fizzy Fang. Fantastic. This is Halloween. Fantastic popcorn. orange flavored popcorn. And that is new. Cannot wait to try that. Mr. Kipling chocolate and slime cakes. Now we did try cakes that were like this, but I don't know if we had. What's it doesn't
that?
Show them
Is
all.
That actually saying?
That's just the country slices.
Oh, that's not saying what they really are normally.
No.
Okay.
These are lime-flavored sponge with decorated chocolate-flavored toppings. So they're lime. We've had the lemon ones, but we didn't have lime when we were there, did we? We had just lemon.
Yeah, I don't think we had lime.
Lemon, and then we had some that were pink that might have been strawberry. But yeah, not lime.
Last Mr. Kipling.
Fiendish Fancies, and we have had the Fancies, French Fancies, is that what they're normally called, French Fancies? These are orange flavor sponge cakes with a vanilla flavor topping covered with orange colored fondant icing. So we have not had these because they actually say orange flavored sponge cake, and we have not had that. This is awesome. Love this.
Ghost egg.
Cadbury ghost egg.
Ghost egg.
Ghost egg. That's what it's supposed to be. Ghost. It's O-O-O. Ghost egg. Was that really annoying?
Green crisp rice ball.
Ooh, it's a spider.
It's a creepy looking
spider. That's Cadbury. Milk chocolate with green crisp rice balls. So it's going to be green on the inside. Mm-hmm. That's cool.
Those are cool looking.
Spookums. M&S Spookums.
Fruit flavored Halloween shapes.
Yeah, so they're like gummies. And they have a skull and crossbones and Frankenstein and a devil. Those are cool.
And they made a portrait of us.
Okay. What is it? Oh, that's cute. Those are cute.
They didn't make me.
Those are foiled solid milk chocolate lollipop.
One's Frankenstein, one's a witch.
And they're chocolate made in the UK, so I don't know.
Yeah, it doesn't say M&S.
It doesn't say like who actually made these, so I'll probably just put Halloween lollipops in the description or something. Thank you. This is absolutely awesome. I love this. This is perfect for me for Halloween. And you know I've been missing Mr. Kipling. Wonder how long these are good. That's the thing with the Mr. Kipling, because they don't have all the preservatives there. November 2nd. So November 9th. November 19th. And the Cadbury are November 15th. So we will just make sure that we try these. We'll probably try them tomorrow anyway, tonight or tomorrow. But when I put them in the cabinet, I will make sure that I eat these first because they expire first. And I'll eat them.
This took a while to get to us. Normally, it doesn't take this long. This was shipped out the 13th of October.
And today's the 29th.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, today's the 29th.
So, 16 days?
Yeah, it took a long time. I mean, they were worried about it. We were worried about it. But thank you so much. I love it. And to Molly, thank you so much for the card. I absolutely love it. I'm going to put it out with my other cards. And so when everybody comes over tomorrow and on Monday for Halloween, they'll be able to see all my cards. Because I'm sure Gavin and Amelia and everybody will be here. I know in other parts of the United States, I think they had their trick-or-treating on Friday night or maybe even tonight. Our trick-or-treat is actually on Halloween. So people will be trick-or-treating on Monday. So you will not see the trick-or-treat video, our trick-or-treaters, until next week's vlog, the following week. Because I would like to set it up on the porch like we did last year.
We've got the better camera this
year. Yeah, we did that last year. We set it up by we set it in between us.
It wasn't this camera though, was it?
Yeah, it was this camera.
Oh, was it this one?
It was this camera. Yeah.
No, I thought it was the other one.
When did we get this camera? Before we went to London?
No, I don't know. Anyway.
Anyway, We set it up to where it's in between us, so when people walk up, then you can see. Yes, and that's what I like to see is what's popular this year. And I'm expecting Trolls.
Trolls will be
Trolls. Big. I think
Batman. Anything Avengers.
Yes, all that's going to be. And we still don't know what Gavin's going to be. He has two costumes.
Yeah, he'll pick that night.
Yeah, he'll pick that night because he had a costume that it still fits him, that's a size smaller than the new costume. But they both fit him, and so I think Christina's just going to let him go.
Let him pick whatever.
Whatever superhero he wants to go as. So, but thank you all very, very much. I will be back in just a few minutes. With Ashley's little thoughts and quotes and prayers and all that. Okay, I told you I was going to go over the Ashley. Last Christmas, she gave me a jar filled with 365 quotes and sayings and Bible verses and all that. I told you I would go over those now, and the reason I'm not going to lollygag around is because I know this video is long enough. I know that it's going to be a long one. So. Without further ado, these are the pieces of paper I pulled out this week. Try being informed instead of opinionated. Really good one. Don't let anyone dull your sparkle. It will always seem impossible until it is done. Nelson Mandela. A person's a person no matter how small. Dr. Seuss. How beautiful to stay silent when someone expects you to be enraged. Let go of the life you had planned so you can embrace the one God created for you. And the last one says, you are my sunshine. So, I hope you all are having a great week. Hope that each and every one of you have a happy Halloween. Kevin and I have really enjoyed the cards that we received in the mail. So, thank you very, very much. I hope you all stay safe. And in next week's video, hopefully you'll get to see some trick-or-treaters. So, I'll see you then.